Hello everyone! In this video, we're going to talk about setting up uDraper’s collider, simulation, and garment components, and how it's changed in the last year since the first video on this topic was released. We're in Unreal 5.1, and I have a basic photo shoot scene set up here. I'm going to go over the component setup with a couple different characters, one that's just a simple skeletal mesh, and one that's a MetaHuman. I'm going to start off with the MetaHuman character, as it has a couple extra pieces to it. If you aren't interested in the MetaHuman character, you can just skip to the next section of this video. I'll need to add the Draper components to this character. I can do that in the level or in the MetaHuman blueprint. For this character, I'm going to add it to the blueprint. Now in the blueprint, under components, select body. Then over in the details, there's a section for Draper. This add button is a new feature. Previously, you would need to go up to the components and add each of them manually, but now this button will quickly get things set up for us. Now over in the components, we have collider, simulation, and garment. I need to add another garment so that I can have shirt and pants. So I'll go up to here and type in Draper and turn off my caps lock. I'll choose garment and rename these so that I don't get confused later. Now by default, this feature will take the body and head and set up LOD 1 and 3 respectively. Note, the collider does not affect the look of the mesh. It is only for collisions with the simulation and will not affect the visible character. The cloth simulation works best with a lower poly count, but not so low as to cause the clothing to clip with the original high poly mesh. If I open this up in the editor, we can see how many verts we're working with at LOD 1. 8.5 is a fine number. Your best performance is cloth simulation colliders that are under 10K. If your character doesn't have lower poly LODs, then you'll need to either have a separate mesh to use for the collider, or you'll need to generate LODs. I will cover that later in the video when I do the Daz character, so you can skip ahead to that if you need to. Even though 8.5 is a fine number, I'm going to show the steps for using a different mesh that shares the same skeleton, which can help with removing things like fingers, toes, or facial features. The cloth isn't going to interact with those, so we don't need them. These simplified meshes have been prepped ahead of time. You can find a link to the mesh simplification tutorial in the description below. Okay, we can close this, and I'm going to go back to the Collider Details panel. So I can search for my simplified bodies here in the search bar, or I can drag and drop them from the content browser. This is going to pop up because my simplified mesh does not have an LOD of 1, it only has an LOD of 0. That's going to say it for both the head and the body. I can just switch this to 0 and then we'll stop getting that message. I can also copy and paste them. Again, same message. Taking a quick look at these, you can see that they have no digits on the hands or the feet. This helps with the simulation, and it also helps keep the cloth from getting torn by the fingers. They are also faceless, because unless the cloth is going to get chewed on by your character, you don't need any of these features. Now, in my case, I only have these two slots. But for some MetaHumans, due to shoes, you'll have a third slot for the feet. In that case, if they need to collide with the clothes, you can add another part right here. But I chose to give this character sandals, which you can judge me for, but I will die on the hill of simplicity. So I'll just delete this. If you did happen to give the character actual shoes, but don't want to have three colliders, or the shoes are too high poly, there's an option when you're using MetaHuman to use the body preview. you will need to create new LODs with reduced triangles. And depending on the shoes, you might need to edit things so that the mesh collider lines up with the shoes. But we'll not go down that rabbit hole in this video. We're gonna stick to a goal here. Now, of course, we'll need to go into the garment and pick the clothing. Depending on if you're working from the 3D garment files or have the ready-to-wear asset version, you'll either need to navigate to the folder with the garment or get the archive that comes with the ready-to-wear garments. For me, I have the 3D garments, so I'm going to navigate to... Previously, uDraper required that the clothing be tailored to the collider mesh for the character, but the latest version allows you to use the same clothes on different characters. That's what this warning is about. It will wrap the garment based on the UVs of the character. We'll talk about that more in a dedicated video. I'm going to decline this because the clothes are fitted for this character already. The wrap option here is important if your character is posed differently, but the garment is fitted correctly either with the UV option or via saving the wrapping information during simulations. I'm going to uncheck this just to prevent the message about the UV wrapping, but it will be automatically checked after saving during the simulation or by using the button at the top of the Draper garment component. Compile the blueprint. And then we can place the character in the level. The hierarchy of the garments can be important as well. You can edit them here in the editor or in the components, which should be here now, with this button. The lowest value is closest to the skin, so a zero is right up against the skin. The highest value is furthest away from the skin, so in our case, jeans, then shirt. This will help to drape the clothing correctly. Now you can hit the play button. You can adjust the garment during the simulation with your cursor. And save it when the animation is running from the Draper editor here. This will preserve the shape that you have defined. And then you can just hit stop. And that's the uDraper components setup process with the MetaHuman character. An important note is that the new add button isn't working with the MetaHuman child blueprint, although you can still add the uDraper components manually. Here's a quick demonstration of how much of a performance boost this whole process adds. This is the low poly mesh that we just created. This is the character with an LOD of 0, using the original MetaHuman mesh. Granted, I'm also running recording software, but even without that, this is a big hit to my FPS. It would be quite difficult to work with this character. Okay, now we're gonna go over the process with a Daz character that has just a single skeletal mesh. Again, we can use the add button to get quickly set up. This is just a message that the character is too high poly, and we will address that by adding LODs to this character. So I can just click OK. For a non-MetaHuman character, the add button will not add a collider component, as it's not needed for a single skeletal mesh. However, you can add the collider component by going up here, typing Draper. If, for example, your character has a number of separate mesh assets, like weapons or accessories that it needs to interact with cloth. In this video, we're keeping it simple since we added the Draper simulation component directly to the skeletal mesh. It's going to use the skeletal mesh as a collider. Let's take a look at the character mesh. So this character has almost 19,000 vertices, but for best performance, we want it to be around 10,000. We can set the LOD for the mesh collider, so all we need to do is make new LODs. To do that, we just go to the LOD settings, and we're going to set this to 2. This will generate LOD 1. And Now we have LOD 0 and 1. Selecting LOD 1, we'll now have a panel for LOD 1, where we can change the percentage of triangles to be about 10 to 7k. Thank you for the autosave. And I'll regenerate these. Now that that's done, we can come back to the uDraper’s simulation component and set the LOD to 1. The uDraper’s simulation component contains a lot of the features you would use to affect said simulation. Hardware, wind, gravity. We'll get to that in another video, but for now, we're all good and we can move to adding clothing to the uDraper’s garment component. I'll use the folder option to navigate to a dress that I know won't quite fit right, and I can demonstrate what to do about that. I just need to correct the wrapping here, so I'll start up the simulation. And thanks to our efforts setting up the collider, I can just pull parts of this around the body of the character, so that they fit better. Okay, once I'm happy with that, I can just save it while the animation is running. And then when I stop it, it's now wrapped. If it reverts to before we played the simulation, you just need to go and make sure that the garment has wrapping checked. And that's it. Ready for a runway, a barefoot runway. Hopefully this helped you get started with the uDraper’s components, and I'll see you in the next video.